फ्रेंड्स। फ्रेंड्स वंस अगेन वी एंटर इनटू द लेक्चर। सो व्हाट हैपेंड इन द पॉलिटिकल डेमोक्रेसी इन इंडिया बिकॉज ऑफ द इवन एंटी डिफेक्शन लॉ इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द श्रीमती इंदिरा गांधी प्रपोज्ड बट इट वाज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द राजीव गांधी स्पिरिट। इट इज आल्सो अमेंडेड। नाउ we are also living in the era of the anti-defection law, but even though there is a lot of political trading, like horse trading, are practicing by the different political parties. Even now, not only horse trading, even reciprocity, internal transactions also done or doing by the different political parties in various methods, various corrupted methods. So then it has become a crisis. So many even leaders are gone to jail because of the political immoralities practices by them. Even P.V. Narasimha, like a vice prime minister of this country, also went jail one day. So what happened? Because of even you're a wise man, sometimes you, because of political need, so survival your governance, some political immorality is also practicing by the even wise man like P.V. Narasimha Rao also. So if P.V. Narasimha Rao, like a person, has done like this, a common uneducated MLA or the common land grabber MLA or MPs can do, even the corporate bodies or the capitalist can do more. So friends, how can we expect the political morality in the corporate politics, in corrupted politics, in selfish politics? So that is the reason it has become a very crisis, big crisis. It is not only in India, elsewhere in the world, most corrupted leaders also went jails, even some death penalty also in some cases of some countries happened because of the political corruptions. So that is the reason political corruption has become very ruthful activity in the world, in India, even in the states of the India. So that is, once the political morality leads to anti-defection law, immorality leads to anti-defection law, then the constitutional crisis will occur. If the majority will come down from ruling party, then opposition party will come into power. Again, then because of jumping Japans and Ayaram Gayarams, then it will become again instable governments. Instable government also will become the constitutional crisis. The stable government will give some fruits rather than the instable governments. Instable governments, leads to collapse of the democracy, collapse of the constitutional principles sometimes. So then it will affect on the democracy, it will automatically affect on the people's and the people's economy, because they will lose, in the name of elections, crores of the rupees. They will loot. So that is the reason it leads to a very, economical crisis, also political crisis, also constitutional crisis. So that is the reason the maintenance of standards of political ethics and moralities are very important to stop this, constitutional crisis by the political parties. Friends, what is the role of the youth? 67% of the youth are there in India. Not only in India, even in Telangana state. So what is their role? They don't know what is the value of a political democracy, at least vote. So, as per constitution, we are equal. We have one vote, one value, and one man, one vote, one value. as per politics we are equal, as per constitution all are equal before the law and equal protection of the laws, but as per society, civil society, we are unequal either socially and economically, even politically also. But political philosophy, as per political concept of the one man, one vote and one value, we are equal. But socially and economically we are unequal. Then how we can bridge the gap between the social inequality, economical inequality, and also leads to the political inequality, which leads to constitutional crisis. So it is a primary duty of the rulers, either in central governments or state governments, to implement the constitutional principles basing on the constitutional democracy, that is political, based on the political morality and political ethics. But until unless if we are failed to do this, definitely India or the states of India will face crisis. It's since 72 years it is facing crisis. The entire these corporate bodies are looting, and the corporate politicians are looting this country, and the corrupted leaders are looting this country, cheating this country, and violating the anti-defection law, and also violating the principles of, you know, the parliament affairs and the assembly affairs. Even they are also violating the speaker norms, rules and regulations. So this was the situation happening because of the persons entering into the holiest bodies. They are not, you know, law abiding citizens. They are not morally fitted citizens. They don't know what is constitution. They don't know what is the fundamentals of constitution. They want only the political power to gain benefits, personal benefits, their family benefits, their community benefits, or their caste benefits. So ultimately it affecting on the people's interest, people's rights, people's welfare. Ultimately it is affect also nation pride, nation honor. So that is the reason I am requesting the youth of this country and this state, if a youth, a strong youth like you, who follows the political moralities or who follow the ethics, they should come into politics. They should lead this politics. Then only the changes will occur in the political scenarios. Best example, if you see little bit, you know, political change has been happened in Uttar Pradesh because of the Kansira movement. So Manishri Kansira movement, a political movement, a political democracy, you know, 85% of the Bahujan Samaj, so deprived of 15% of the people. So because of that reason, he made Ut Hamara Raj Tumara Nahi Chalega Nahi Chalega. Then tremendous political changes has been occurred in the UP. Is one of the key state for the North India. But why this is not happening in South? There is no leader, such a leader like, you know, Kanchiram. If you see Kejriwal is one of the model leader for North India. So he is a North Indian, a leader which, you know, having a very, you know, highly educated, and also who fight against of the corrupted politics. So he has came into power, he making the Delhi model, you know, for instead of the Gujarat model. So Gujarat model is a very capitalistic model, but Delhi model is a common people oriented model. Why not in South? Hyderabad model. So we should make a South Hyderabad model as in a holistic model, a political, you know, moralistic model, a people's oriented democratic models. People's oriented politics should be. Do that. Then only we may expect some changes in the political scenario. Ultimately, it leads to social change, economical change, and political change to promote India into egalitarian society or Nav Bharat or Nav Telangana. Otherwise, definitely the crisis of constitution and the crisis of the politics. the crisis of the political democracy, political morality will still continues. The it will become a constitutional challenge. Thank you very much. This is the last topic from the constitutional law and new challenges. Thank you, friends. So I have covered all topics from the constitutional law and new challenges. So from March onwards, the leftover parts also covered by my online classes, and also from the YouTube, by making of YouTube videos. So ultimately I completed the syllabus, and also I have given important questions, a model internal questions. So thank you very much for giving this beautiful time for share my views about the constitutional and new challenges. Thank you, friends.